Call me redneck, I reckon that I am, but there's things going on that make me mad to the core. I gotta work like...
Alright, what up y'all? Sorry for it being so kind of dark. I'm underneath a shade tree right now, but my refrigerator just stopped working. So I had to get online to find out what it was. And this is only for refrigerators that are flashing a 5 green code. So in other words, what it means is if your refrigerator is not cooling and it flashes 5 times green and then it goes back to solid. And then it flashes 5 times green and it goes back to solid. This is what it is. And according to what I found online, this means that my motherboard needs to be reset. So I figured instead of just doing it, that I would record it so that way you guys could see what I'm doing. So I'm going to turn this around and I'm going to show you. I've already got the cover off. I haven't taken anything apart yet. I've got the electricity shut off to the rig. And let me show you what I got. Okay, so this is the back of the refrigerator. And this is the motherboard. And I'm going to end up having to take pictures of this, but I figured what I'll do to begin with is I'm going to go inside. I'm going to turn everything back on before I fuck with anything so I can show you what it's been doing. The 5 flashing lights and then it goes back to solid. Now, I was told that if there's any yellow stuff or any smell of ammonia, that means this is leaking right here. Well, I don't see anything leaking, but boy, that son of a gun is hot. I can tell you that right now. So, and I think it has to do with the weather here. I'm not sure, but I can tell you right now that it's not in the sunlight, that I still have shade on the back side. You can see that I have a little bit of shade. But I don't know what happened, so I'm going to try to jump the motherboard and see if I can get this back going. But I did read online that if something's wrong, it could cause a fire if I keep trying to reset it. And I don't want to burn myself up. So we're going to try this one time and see if this works. But I'm going to go inside. I'm going to turn the power back on and I can show you guys what the refrigerator is doing. So hold on. So this is what it's doing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this means that the motherboard outside has quit working. So I'm going to shut this off. And yes, I know it's a little windy, but I went ahead and unplugged it just to be on the safe side. So my cord's laying on the ground so that way I don't have to worry about being electrocuted or anything trying to work on this. So I'm going to shut this off for a minute and get my tools all ready. Okay, just so you guys know, it's a quarter inch is what it is. I'll turn this around and show you what I'm talking about. Okay, you see that head right there? That's one. There's a second one over here. And I'm going to have to move this stuff out of the way so you can see it. Number two is like right back in there. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. And then number three is right up there on top. And all three of those have got to be taken off. So let me take these off real quick.
Ting tang, walla walla bang bang. Ooh ee ooh ah ah. Ting tang, walla walla bang bang. Ooh ee ooh ah ah. Ting tang, walla walla bang bang. Ooh ee ooh ah ah. Ting tang, walla walla bang bang. Do 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 do.
Looks like we got company across the way. Thank you. All right, y'all, you have to give me a minute. Well, what I was saying before I accidentally freaking shut the video off is I've got to take a picture of these cords, make sure I get them put back where they go, and then I'll be back. All right, y'all, I got the cover taken off, and now that I got this back on, I have got to turn this back off. I got to look at the picture I just took and make sure I get the wires put back on where they exactly go, and then I will turn this back on and show you the next step. All right, y'all, if you noticed, I got the wires put back on. Oh, I forgot to plug this one back in real quick. Okay, I got that one plugged back in. Now what I did was I made a jumper wire. This jumper wire has to go into this number two slot right here, and then has to go down to the ground wire, which is right there, if you guys can see that. So I have to jump it. So now I gotta go turn the power back on and then see if I can jump this real quick. Just so you guys know, I've been very careful. I do not smell ammonia. I do not see any yellow buildup or anything, but it was pretty damn hot. So I don't know if this thing just got way too hot and it automatically shut off. I've dealt with this a couple times where it has shut off before, but then I turn it off and I turn it back on and it comes right back on. This time it's not coming back on. I will tell you, to replace a motherboard is about $300 and some dollars, and I don't have that right now. So I'm praying to God me jumping this off is what makes it come back on and it works, at least until I can get other shit done. If not, I'm gonna have to fully take this damn thing completely out and put an electric fridge in, and that ain't gonna work. So anyway, let's see if this is gonna work. Alright, y'all, I was out there screwing for it with a while, trying to jump it. There was no spark, no nothing. I have no clue what's wrong with it. I can't get it to, you're supposed to use a jumper in the second hole and then hold it to the ground. It's supposed to click and turn back on. It never did that. So, and I know those boards are $350 because I already had to buy one for my old refrigerator I had in my first Class A. I don't want to have to go that route. So if anybody has any suggestions on what to do, please leave them in the comments, because I don't know what else to do. I've tried, I take it apart, I've done everything I can, and I've watched video after video on different ones. Mine is an older one. This is pre-2006, so it has the older motherboard on it. So any suggestions, I'd be welcome to take them. I just don't know what to do. So I went and bought two bags of ice and put them in the fridge and the freezer, and we'll just have to see how that goes and see how long that lasts. I don't want my shit spoiling, and I just filled up the fridge and the freezer. So yeah, any suggestions, please leave them below. All right, y'all, have a good day. Love one another, be kind to one another, and live life to the fullest, because tomorrow's not promised, and I'm back in a bad mood. So, anyway, I love each and every one of you. God bless, and have a great day. All right, y'all. Not too much in the mood for story time, but I've got a couple short ones that I'll tell you. And they both have to do with when I worked with Rusty Wallace and did his show car. I was on my way from Brooklyn, Michigan, which is where we were stationed at that time at the Michigan International Speedway. That's where the show cars were at. And I was on my way out to Fontana, California. And I was taking 80 out, and then I hit 70, and then down to 40, and then across. And then I think I ended up on 20, and then hit, went ahead and went into Fontana out of 20. Anyway, I know I was going through Oklahoma. I had just went through Oklahoma City, and it was probably about, I don't know, 3, 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Now, I know you guys know what the older cars are, at least the older people do, where they have the open floorboards, not like today's cars where they have the consoles and everything in them. Back in like the 70s and the 80s, they had the open floorboards where you could actually get down there and sit down, or you could put a bunch of shit on the floorboard. Anyway, so these two girls in an old Buick, and I remember it was a Buick, it was a four-door old Buick. And I don't know if it was a 70s or an 80s model, but they come, it was burgundy, I do remember that. They came up beside me, and I'm just kind of driving, and they looked, I looked down towards them, and they look up at me, and they're waving, and they're smiling, and they're doing this thing, and then they kind of back off a little bit, and then they get behind the trailer, and I'm like, what in the world's going on? Are they following me, or what? And so they come back around, but I only seen one girl this time. And I'm trying to figure out, I'm like, what the hell's going on? They get up beside me, literally, and no bullshit. The one girl is driving with her legs spread across the street seat. The other girl is in the floorboard going to town on her beside me while I'm driving. I was like, damn. So that is, I didn't know what to say. I didn't know what to do. I was shocked, and they both were looking up, and the one was that was in between the other girl's legs was looking up sideways as she's going to town. I'm trying not to get too explicit here for the lady viewers that watch, so you guys understand what I'm saying. Well, then there's another one that I had 14 days up in Washington State. Actually, it was 19 days. And while I was up there, I met this girl. My bad. That's a different one. I was still in Fontana, and I had met this chick at a little dirt track, and she wanted pictures of her on the car. And I'm like, that's cool. I said, but don't be denting it. And this, I said, I'm totally responsible for anything that happens to this car, and it's my ass if it gets screwed up. She strips down butt-ass naked and very carefully gets on the car and lays her titties across the windshield from the top of the cab and wanted me to take pictures. Needless to say, old Puddin' got lucky that night. She was pretty hot. She had some big old titties, too. I'm talking like 38 triple D. Like, they were huge. Even though my second ex-wife had bigger hooters. But these were pretty big. So, and that's the second story. I had met her at a dirt track, and she just told me she wanted pictures taken. And I'm like, yeah, no problem. You know, just be careful. You know, it's a $300,000 race car. I don't want it fucked up. I just put the car inside the trailer. It was a Featherlite trailer. I just put it inside, and she wanted pictures of it, and I shut the, because she goes, well, can you shut the door while I get pictures? I'm like, yeah, no problem. So I shut the door, and as soon as I did, I mean, she's stripping all of her clothes off. I mean, down to butt-ass naked. Needless to say, we kind of shined the hood of the race car that night. So those are my two stories for the day. I hope you enjoyed, and I kid you not, this shit happened, and there's a lot more of this stuff to come. Not a lot of sex stories and shit, but I've got a lot of wild stories that has actually happened to me, but those are two that were kind of the more funner ones that I guess you could say. So anyway, y'all be good, love one another, be kind to one another, live life to the fullest, and remember, tomorrow's not promised, and my fridge is dead. So anybody have any comments about it, please leave it in the description below, because I could use any kind of help I could get right now. So I love y'all, and have a great night. God bless.
So put your drinks up for the weekend, cause them workday sure been creeping. What's up? Is anybody gonna get tore up?